Hey there! Welcome to the Overcomers of Relapse podcast. I am Dee, your host. This is episode 5 of season 12 of my podcast. So welcome to all listeners out there. Hey, it is great to share this experience with you. You know, I decided with the introduction of each episode of this season to start off with a session I would like to call the Let's Feel Good. You heard me, my friends. You see, I believe sometimes we just need a moment. I mean, just a moment to get away from the troubles of the world. And what better way to do that than just sit back and enjoy great music? Hey, great music that just makes you feel really good. You know, I personally find good feel-good music a great tool to escape the pressure and anxiety of our everyday, busy, stressful lives. Now, I do not own the copyright to this song. It is used for feeling good purposes only. So my listening friends, hey, sit back or do like me. Get up and dance. Put all of your troubles on the side. And come on and join me. Let's feel good. Hey, I will be right back with today's exciting topic and discussion. Enjoy.
Teachers that done praise me,
shout out, shout out.
To anyone who tried to hate on me, yeah,
shout out.
Even the ones who tried to break me, even the ones who tried to take me down. Hold on to pain, but that ain't what my life's about. I ain't blaming nobody if I ain't got my stuff worked out. I got a life for myself, ain't gonna regret anything I've done. I just wanna sing my song, ain't got nothing but love for all the players on the streets.
Shout out, shout out.
To all my ghetto doing y'all thing.
My crew from way back when,
way back when.
To the goers and the stayers,
oh yeah.
And the ones that I ain't met,
for myself for sticking with me, yeah.
For the ones I miss,
oh. Anyone who's ever been a part of me ain't got nothing but love.
None but love.
Hey, my listening friends, I don't know about you, but that works for me, man. That definitely was some feel-good music. Because when you learn to love people in spite of whatever, and definitely when you learn to love yourself in spite of whatever, what an accomplishment and an eye-opening event of life. So I hope you enjoyed that feel-good moment. Hey, now let's get started. I just want to put this out there right from the beginning. This podcast is not only pertaining to relapse virus drugs, alcohol, or any other addictions. Friends, we are open to all topics. However, our main topic is why do we have addictive behaviors and how can we overcome them? On episode 5 of season 12, I would like to use for a topic, express priority. Yes, my listening friends, express priority. You know, my listening friends, when I thought of this topic, a question came to my mind to ask all my listeners. What do you consider as your number one priority in your life? Hey, my listening friends, if you ask any recovering addict this question, and their response is not sobriety, staying clean, living drug free, hey, in my opinion, their chances of a successful recovery, hey, is in serious jeopardy. You see, my friends, this is the root of every other quality of life existence for the recovering person who suffers from the disease of addictions. See, we as recovering addicts, we have to express this as our number one priority in life. And that is maintaining our recovery to make a life that is worth living. Are we always going to get everything completely right? Hey, let's be honest here. For most of us, there are going to be some slip-ups, some relapses, complicated craving mental moments. Hey, but my listening friends, however, we must always, always remember, in order for us to stay even possibly have a successful recovery, your recovery from addiction, hey, it has to be your number one priority. You know, I personally have lost, friendships and some family members' relationships, simply because I decided to express that I am trying to do everything I can to try and live in a recovered state of being, a recovered life. Hey, they felt that I was trying to be better than them, and they just felt like, why couldn't I just not accept and enjoy living my addicted behavior lifestyle with them? Now, anyone who listens to my podcasts or has checked out any of my videos knows that I am a very, very transparent person. And I am not ashamed or worry at all what others may think or their opinions of me. You know, and the reason why is, if my story can help someone else with their recovery, I am more than willing to share it all. You know, I come from a family where alcoholism, it was considered the norm. If you didn't drink, something was wrong with you. And I did not realize how toxic the lifestyle was until I changed the company I was hanging around. You see, my listening friends, some people, some associates, do not wish for you to change for the better. They prefer that you stay on the same level they are, and they will not support you in your recovery. Because, you know, it's like the old saying, misery really does love company. You know, listening friends, I remember when I first came to the conclusion that I was an addict and I knew I really needed help. Hey, now, I have to admit, change for anyone, and especially for me sometimes, change is not easy. And right to this day, hey, I still have my days. I struggle with maintaining my sobriety. And to be honest with you, if most recovering addicts would be honest with you, they would tell you that fighting addiction disease, hey, it's an everyday battle. Now, yes, of course, some days are easier than others. However, there are days that are very, and I do mean very, challenging. I mean, come on, friends. Let's be real here. We are fighting a very cunning and baffling disease that is willing, hey, to take all prisoners that will participate. So, you know, as my journey on recovery continues, anytime I made a mistake and slipped or relapsed, the first thing I would hear, and this is the honest truth, the first thing that would get back to me is gossip of friends and loved ones. This is what they would say. See, I told you he was not going to be able to change. He is a drunk, and that is all there is to it. You know, listening friends, I used to find these remarks shocking because, you know, it just seems to me that the people that's supposed to love you the most, hey, you would expect them to be more supportive to you with, you know, exemplifying expressions of love and understanding of you trying to better yourself by the continuality of you trying, at least trying, no matter how many times you have fallen, at least you are trying to make sobriety your number one priority. Huh. Hey, sometimes it's a big letdown. So, you know what, my listening friends? What I had to learn is this. It is no one's responsibility, nor should I or you depend on the love and support of others to make my recovery my number one priority. That is my responsibility. Now, listen to this. Here is the real shocker. This, my friends, actually even happens with your fellow recovery addicts friendships. I mean, friends that are addicts, this happens with them also. You know, I have had friends that were in recovery, hey, just like me. And when they decided that it was not working, they just decided, hey, this is not even worth trying anymore. This is what they would say to me. Hey, this is not even worth it, dude. This is not even worth trying anymore. Trying to stay sober for themselves, well, it just became out of the question. And then they would attempt to take me along with them. And they would try to convince me. And they would say things like, man, hey, come on. What's the use in us keep trying? We are who we are. It is just a matter of time. We are going to relapse anyway. Hey, buddy, let's drop this sober thing and, hey, let's go get a real drink. Hey, listen to me very closely, listening friends. This is dangerous territory. If you are not careful, because the disease of the addiction whisperer, that is the disease that whispers in your ear and in your mind and in your spirit, it will start talking to you why the person is talking to you. And it will say things like, you know what? He is absolutely right. A drink would really be great right now. And you know what? Chances are, I am not going to make it in recovery anyway. Hey, my listening friends, I have a simple answer for this. Don't listen and do not do it. It is just a temporary temptation, but it can be a long-term regret. You see, my listening friends, the key is to always remind yourself, express sobriety as your number one priority. See, my friends, nothing else can become number one in your life as a recovery addict. The minute you make your expression of your recovery your second priority, hey, you know this, everything else will become a non-priority to you except another drink or another fix of your drug of choice. Hey, my listening friends, I'm not here to judge anyone. And, you know, everyone has a right to choose what they believe is right for them. Some addicts have chosen. They have made their choice. Hey, this is my life, and this is how I choose to live it. And, hey, you know, far as I am concerned, that is okay. It is your choice. That is the gift of every individual. We get to choose our own options. However, for me, I know I have to fight this addiction disease every day of my life. Hey, some battles I may lose, but I intend, trust me, on winning the war. And the strategy I am using is making sure I express in some kind of fashion every day sobriety as my number one priority of my life every minute of the day. Because in my opinion, hey, if sobriety becomes my second priority, then, hey, the reality is I have chosen a slow death as my first priority. And hey, I don't know about anyone else. I can only speak for me. But if the choices is choosing to live and not to die, I don't even have to consider making sobriety my second priority. I mean, let's face it. Let's really get honest here. If I am gone and I make sobriety my second choice, who is going to enlighten you with all these great podcasts? Hey, my listening friends, please, please, I beg of you, please, express recovery as your number one priority. Because someone out there needs your help. And what you have to realize, by helping them choose recovery as their number one priority, it is a constant reminder to you as well. And also, it is a great way of helping and serving others. And my friends, that is worth living for. Hey, my friends, choose wisely. Well, that's it. That's it for episode 5 of season 12. And you already know, my friends, I will be ending this podcast with that great meditation track. So please stay tuned to the very end of the podcast episode. Hey, come on. Let's take a fight on angel wings together. Hey, my listening friends, please visit my website, The Overcomers of Relapse Lounge. It is listed on the screen. Hey, feel free to post on the blog, share any thoughts that you may have, and also feel free to use the instant chat. And my friends, all of my contact information is on there also, with a lot of great music. And also, my friends, come join my Facebook group called The Overcomers of Relapse Lounge. Hey, I'm telling you, we have a lot of great inspiring posts and just a great, great group of people to chat with. And come on, my friends, come on. Don't forget to listen and send in those questions for the Ask Me segments. Hey, you know me. It is always my pleasure to serve and help in any way that I can. Come on, friends, let me know your opinions and thoughts, and also if you would like to be a guest on the podcast. Thanks again for joining me, and I will talk with you all again very, very soon. Take care of yourselves out there. Bye-bye. Thank you.